Very significant to us as Christians today because we are honoring Christ and also worshiping Him.
At Easter, Christians observe Galilee Day.
The president is very, very concerned. And not only very concerned, he got it right.
Former President Obasanjo gives thanks to the military for clipping the wings of insurgents. A check on fuel supplies by policymakers. Plus, Nigeria loses top political ideologue. Good evening. Thanks for joining us on NTA Network News. And here's wishing you the best of the season and hope you had a fine holiday. As Christians observe going to Galilee with prayers and churches, clerics enjoin them not to forget the reason for the season. Ifeanyi Izumba reports.
An outing with the children and less privileged as the Commonwealth of Zion Assembly organized a fun fair. For the senior pastor of the church, touching lives is very paramount.
When people are at your mercy, don't kick any man that is on the ground. I want you to see it as a privilege.
We cannot grow as a people except we go back to the source. We must return back to our own values.
From the tradition of the day, it is believed that it enables the faithful to be spiritually equipped for greater exploits for God and humanity as clergymen to launch Christians to love one another and be upright.
That we can contribute to building this nation, and we should bring those strengths together and make sure that Nigeria becomes a great nation.
As Nigerians, we are facing a lot of challenges, but there is still hope for this nation. We only need to be very patient with the present government.
In Abuja, Ifeanyi Izumba, NTA News.
Today, Easter Monday, called Galilee Day, was Christians in Abuja marked it, continuing the celebration of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Oyinnaya Kaluoka witnessed the service by members of Ekwa Church.
According to the scripture, after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, he requested for his apostles to meet him at Galilee. Depicting the scenario, worshippers of the evangelical church winning all Ekwa, in Gerki and Apo, before the dawn of the day, were already on top of the hill.
Very significant to us as Christians today because we are honoring Christ and also worshiping Him.
Worshippers were reminded of the lessons of Easter, which is considered the central tenet of Christianity.
That Jesus is resurrected. There is a testimony. He has come for peace. And he said, those that crucify him, he has forgiven them. So we should learn how to forgive one another.
Christ lives, and Christ is our altar and the finisher of our faith.
It is some time to go into the world and preach the gospel.
At the end of the service, they were filled with joy celebrating the risen Christ. In Abuja, Oyinnaya Kaluoka, NTA News.
Now, the Easter celebration took a more festive turn on Monday as Christians celebrated the ascension of Jesus Christ. Joy Uzo, who went round Abuja, reports that Nigerians used the day to reflect on the message of Easter as a catalyst to boost peaceful coexistence and lasting peace in Nigeria.
Easter Monday over the years has taken up more significance beyond being the day after the resurrection. In many theological interpretations, Easter Monday is a reenactment of the injunction in Galilee, where the risen Christ appeared to his disciples for the last time, instructing them to preach the gospel across the earth. Today, Christian period to reflect on this sacrifice and attempt to use it to spread the message of peace to all mankind.
We are Nigerians, we are all put here by God. We should celebrate one another, enjoy one another, encourage one another, and have a better nation.
Different activities eroded the celebration, with churches organizing picnics to celebrate the ascension. The mood was also replicated in parks and resorts across the Federal Capital Territory.
It's obviously a behave of activities here at the Abuja Millennium Park as fun seekers are taking advantage of the spacious nature of this park to bask in the euphoria of Easter.
I'm out with my family so that we can come and have fun and share the joy of Easter with other families. In Abuja, Joy Uzo, NTA News.
Nigerians should learn to imbibe the common values of love, sincerity, integrity, and hard work that the major religions preach for progress and social harmony. Guests on NTA's Good Morning Nigeria program made the submission on harnessing religious values for national reformation. Patricia Isamilubba reports.
Religion, as observed by the guest, has been the opium of the poor and the mobilizer. It is therefore an asset for any nation that wants to strive high. Bringing the state and the religion together, Sam Smart said, is what makes for development and above all, bind the society together.
Religion binds. Religion creates solidarity. I see religious values as an asset to any nation.
Archbishop of the Catholic Diocese of Abuja, John Cardinal Onaiyekan, enjoined Nigerians to imbibe the culture of peace, tolerance and harmonious coexistence towards the enthronement of a progressive society.
You will then realize, therefore, that where problems arise, the so-called differences between religions are generally not on very essential matters.
The Constitution can incorporate, so to speak, provisions of religions to sanitize our behavioral terrain.
Further appeal to religious leaders to work in synergy with the government in order to achieve peaceful coexistence for the nation. In Abuja, Patricia Isamilubba, NTA News.
Former President Olusegun Obasanjo has commended the effort of the military in curtailing the Boko Haram insurgency in the northeast region. He gave the commendation when he visited Governor Kashim Shettima in Maiduguri. Pauline Kujevana reports.
President Obasanjo welcomed his rating with the government and people of Borno State over the calamity that had befell them, commended President Muhammadu Buhari for the deployment of troops to clear all areas hitherto occupied by the Boko Haram, thereby restoring normalcy. He called on Nigerians to reflect on the lessons learned from the insurgency, expressing the hope that such calamity should be averted in future.
The President is very, very concerned. And not only very concerned, he has right.
Governor Kashim Shettima appreciated Olusegun Obasanjo for his effort in 2011 to establish a channel of negotiation with the Boko Haram militants.
The fight against Boko Haram has largely been well driven under the Buhari administration, and we are more hopeful that the end of Boko Haram is closer than it ever was.
Vice Chancellor of the University of Maiduguri, Professor Ibrahim Jodi, said Obasanjo is in Borno to commission some projects at the university as part of activities to mark the institution's 40th anniversary. At the Shehu's Palace, Obasanjo urged the citizens to cooperate with the federal government in its effort to sanitize the polity. The royal father expressed gratitude to the former president for identifying with the people of Borno at the peak of the insurgency. In Maiduguri, Pauline Kujevana, NTA News.
The air component of Operation Lafia Duli and internally displaced persons at the Deluri camp in Maiduguri, Borno State, were not left out of the Easter celebration as they had time out with the Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar. Defence correspondent KG Busari Ahmed reports.
To mark the Easter period, the almost 30,000 internally displaced persons at the Deluri camp, Maiduguri, the Borno State capital, were treated to sumptuous meals and also got medical attention, courtesy of the Nigerian Air Force, as the Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, visited the camp. Several medical conditions were attended to. During the visit by the Chief of Air Staff, the troop ran into an old woman, Kakazara, well over 90 years of age, and a lady, Yazara Maman, who had been held hostage for days without food or water by the insurgents around Shashari village near Alagano Forest.
She was rescued and the helicopter evacuated her here. So far our assessment shows that she's just hungry. We understand she's been in custody of the Boko Haram for days without eating.
Kakazara is currently receiving medical attention at the Nigerian Air Force Base, Maiduguri. And The air components of the Operation Lafia Dole also got their morale boosted by the leadership of the Nigerian Air Force celebrating the festive period with the troop. The Air Chief assured them of total welfare package and equipment as well as logistics to enhance their performance.
Greetings from the Commander-in-Chief to them for the good works they have been doing in order to keep the Northeast stable. For the IDPs, we also believe that we have some level of responsibility to try and see how we can provide medical requirements for them.
Wherever we are, we must be supportive of this country.
It was indeed another level of morale boosting with the air component of Operation Lafia Dole at the theater of war, as the Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, find time to celebrate Easter with the troops, both in Yola and Maiduguri. And the internally displaced persons were not left out. KG Busari Ahmed, NTA News.
President Muhammadu Buhari has felicitated with the national leader of the All Progressives Congress, APC, Bola Ahmed Tinubu, as it clocks 64 on March 29, 2016. A statement from the Presidential Advisor on Media and Publicity, Femi Adesina, commended the outstanding qualities and rising political profile of Asiwaju Tinubu since he was elected the senator in 1992. This, the president believes, is a testimony of the celebrant's righteousness, diligence, and doggedness that had endeared him to the electorate and given him all-round success as a private sector worker, businessman, and politician. The president also commended his visionary leadership style for creating a formidable opposition to oust a party that had been in power for 16 years. President Buhari assures Asiwaju Tinubu that his patriotism and commitment to democracy, good governance and generosity will be appreciated by many generations, and he prayed God to grant him good health, wisdom and prosperity. And similarly, the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Yakubu Dogara, has also described former Lagos Governor and Chieftain of the APC, Bola Tinubu, as a formidable political force who has brought changes to the political landscape of Nigeria. In a statement by his spokesman, Turaiki Hassan, the Speaker congratulated him on his 64th birthday and extended the felicitation of the members of the House to the great party leader for his exceptional feat. He also prayed God to crown his efforts with success. Astute legal practitioner, activist and founder of the National Advance Party, Dr. Tunji Braithwaite, is dead. He died on Monday in a private hospital in Lagos at the age of 82. Musa Toliat was at his Victoria Island residence in Lagos.
To sit down and reconfigure and jettison the old system, a system that has, you know, that has fueled corruption everywhere, judiciary, administration, and everywhere.
Late Dr. Tunji Braithwaite was known for his courageous approach to national issues and his bold stance in fighting for the downtrodden. Sympathizers continue to arrive at number 9, Taslim Elias residence of late Dr. Tunji Braithwaite in Victoria Island, to commiserate with his wife and other members of the family. Apart from pouring out their emotions on the condolence register, some join in prayer sessions for God to give the family the strength to bear the loss.
He had a brief illness and passed away. So I commiserate today with all Nigerians because we have seen the exit of a giant.
Family, friends, as well as those who worked directly with the late legal icon and activist say the incident remains a rude shock.
And President Muhammadu Buhari has commiserated with the family, friends and well-wishers of elder statesman and pro-democracy activist Dr. Tunji Braithwaite, who passed away this Monday. President Buhari believes that the passing away of the lawyer, author and politician came at a time when his wisdom, intellectual depth, vast knowledge and experience were needed by the country. The president urges political leaders to emulate the virtues of the founder of the NAP during the Second Republic, who perceive politics as a platform for honest service to the nation rather than an opportunity to make money. In a statement signed by the Senior Special Assistant to the President on Media and Publicity, Garba Shehu, the President notes that the elder statesman was quintessentially selfless, patriotic, and committed to national development. I pray that the Almighty God will grant his soul eternal rest and comfort his loved ones. And still ahead, multinational maritime security exercise ends. The details shortly.
If you hear a bomb explosion or gunshots of an active shooter, that might be a terror attack. At such times, always remember three action words. Run, hide, report. Don't try to run towards the terror scene to save the situation, because there might be a second bomb blast or another attack. Run far away and take cover. Make sure you are safe first. Yes, it is in our nature to sympathize over the hurt, but remember, only trained personnel can help in such situations. When in a secured environment, promptly call relevant authorities and help will come. For anonymous reporting, call 09630-3250-5 or 0813-2222-106. If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism. This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture.
When you look at the world today, what do you see? The obvious, or much more? Do you hear a color tune, or the talents of thousands paying off? Do you see an instant message, or millions of strengthened relationships? Do you see an app, or creative entrepreneurs? An email, or multiples of successful business transactions? Do you see charity or renewed faith in our shared humanity? Do you hear the laughter of millions of people in Africa's largest family? It's never enough to see only what's before us. That's why MTN is empowering a tomorrow that's driven by digital technology and made for Africa by Africans.
There is a reason Africa is called the new frontier. What was once potential is now an opportunity ready to be seized. Once revered for our resources, today's wealth lies in our people. People who build the cities that shape the future. People who know an idea in one place means business in another. A generation for whom technology means there are no borders, no boundaries. We are the new lions in a brave new world, kings of the urban jungle. And there's a bank that puts the world in our pocket and the future in our hands. UBA, Africa's global bank.
You get three kinds of moms. The paranoid mom. The cautious mom and the Dettol mom. She only trusts Dettol antiseptic liquid to protect her family from up to 100 illness-causing germs, and it's recommended for cuts and scrapes. Which is why you can worry less and love more. Don't just be any mom, be a Dettol mom.
The Inspector General of Police, IGP Solomon E. Rassi, cordially invites the general public to the 11th Biennial Police Games and the 2016 Police Week, scheduled as follows. March 19, 2016, opening ceremony, National Stadium, Abuja. March 21st, Police Week Career Talk. March 22nd, Quiz Competition, National Universities Commission, Abuja. March 25th, Friday Jumat Service, National Mosque, Abuja. March 26th, Walk Curtain, Walk Against Crime, and Games Closing Ceremony.
Ceremony, March 27, Sunday Service National Christian Center, Abuja. March 28, Medical Community Outreach. March 29, Power Community Outreach. March 30, Seminar and Book Launch, National Universities Commission, Abuja. 1st April 2016, Grand Finale. Parades, displays, awards, exhibition and police talent show. Eagle Square, Abuja. Gala Night, International Conference Center, ICC, Abuja. Signed, A.R. James O. Corkery, FSR, Chairman, Central Planning Committee, announcer.
If you work hard and sow, you deserve a good harvest. That's only fair. If you study hard, you deserve good grades. That's only fair. If you train hard, you deserve to win the prize. That's only fair. If you work hard as an employee, you should have something to show for it. That's only fair. At Premium Pension, we understand it's what you put in that guarantees a secure future. Talk to us today about your pension plan. Premium Pension. The future starts now.
To keep my family healthy, I take time to make everything look clean.
Yes, but is it really clean? Let me show you. This is why 80% of hygiene-related illnesses are acquired at home. Some cleaners don't kill germs, others kill germs, but don't clean properly. The new Dettol Multi-Surface Cleaner. 10 times better germ kill, 10 times better cleaning, and all-day freshness. 10 times better cleaning and germ kill for a healthy home.
Dettol, endorsed by the Nigerian Medical Association.
Buy the new Dettol 55 gram soap for 80 naira only. Keep your family protected from germs.
Thanks for staying with us on the news. The Speaker of the House of Representatives, Yakubu Dogara, has dissociated himself from a media report which credited him with describing the fire disaster in Kano on Saturday as a punishment from God. Spokesman for the Speaker, Turaki Hassan, stated that the said report does not in any way represent the opinion and official position of the Speaker. He noted that as a responsible leader, the Speaker could never have blamed the incident on the same people who lost their property worth millions of naira. The Speaker said what the people need at this moment of their loss is empathy. He therefore apologized to the Kano State Government and the victims that are offended by the said statement, which was issued by an aide without clearance and sanctioned by him. While sympathizing with the victims, the Speaker called for full-scale investigation by relevant authorities to unravel the remote and immediate causes of the frequent fire disasters in the Sabongari market. He also consoled those who lost their property in a similar incident in Kebbi State. The Senate Committee on Petroleum Downstream Sector has criticized the unabated scarcity of petroleum products and queues at filling stations. It was during an oversight visit to some petrol stations within the Federal Capital Territory. National Assembly correspondent Kenneth Nanim reports.
Though some of the filling stations visited were dispensing fuel at the official pump price, the committee observed shortage in supply as a major challenge.
On a normal day, 6 trucks is okay for us. It's 40,000 capacity. But with the trend of demand now, it's not adequate.
While Oando filling station at Zone 4 had no product, the Total station at Area 11 Junction was getting ready to offload supply. Committee members expressed displeasure over the situation.
In furtherance of this assessment, we have already invited the Minister of Petroleum Resources, the Minister of State, to appear before the committee to tell us about this problem, tell us his strategy on how to solve this problem, and give us a date when this problem will be solved permanently.
Unacceptable by Nigerians that we continue to remain in queues.
Meanwhile, black marketers are using the opportunity to make brisk business while the long queues at the filling stations linger. Kenneth Nanim, NTA News.
The 2016 exercise Obangame Sahara, involving the coastlines of Senegal and the Gulf of Guinea, has ended in Douala with a challenge to the cooperating regional navies to step up joint patrols for safe and secured maritime domains. Defence correspondent Mohamed Abdul Kadri was there.
The first phase of the regional maritime exercise covered 420 nautical miles national coastline from Badagry to Calabar as part of measures to checkmate illegalities on the waters.
Our SBS too has been brought to bear the experience gained in the times of training they've had with our international partners.
The whole essence of the exercise is to inculcate a very high sense of professionalism in the way we tackle maritime challenges within our sub-region.
Participating ships, including NNS Prosperity, top up from Lagos, NNS Opabana, cast off from Port Harcourt, while Centenary navigate from Calabar, and the Nigerian Navy helicopter provided area surveillance.
The landing of the Nigerian Navy helicopter on the Elo deck is no doubt a force multiplier for the exercise of Obangame Sahara Express.
The final phase of the exercise on the Cameroonian waters featured unopposed compliant boarding of NNS Okpabana by the Cameroonian Navy Special Forces and vice versa. In the exercise that recorded 26 participating countries including US, Togo, France, Guinea, Ghana, Germany, and Senegal.
From Douala, Cameroonian waters, on board NNS Okpabana, Mohamed Abdul Kadri, NTA News.
A clear understanding of the teachings of religion has been identified as a panacea for sustainable peace and conflict resolution in curbing involvement in insurgency activities in the country. Sokoto State Governor Aminu Waziri Tambuwal said this at the Fountain University Convocation Lecture in Oshogbo. Olajide Bello reports.
Commending President Muhammadu Buhari's holistic approach towards tackling insurgency in the country, Governor Aminu Waziri Tambuwal called for the support of Nigerians to bring the activities of insurgents to a halt and restore peace to the northeast.
The nation therefore needs to evolve a system of leadership selection and accountability, which produces the sort of leaders that can confront the challenges associated with our history, socioeconomic inequality, and the establishment of strong institutions for democracy and good governance.
The Sultan of Sokoto, Muhammad Sa'ad Abubakar, cleared the grey, describing Islam as a religion of peace.
Where are we told to build ourselves up with explosives, get into a gathering like this and take hundreds or thousands of lives? And you will never find any answer anywhere in the Holy Quran or in the Sunnah of our most noble leader, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
They both emphasized the importance of education, saying it will go a long way towards curbing involvement in criminal activities under the disguise of religion. In Abuja, Olajide Bello, NTA News.
The people of Daura Emirate have been urged to commit President Muhammadu Buhari to prayers to succeed in putting the country on a sustainable socio-economic and political development. Emir of Daura, Umar Farouk, said this while addressing the Daura Forum. Aminu Ishak Abbas has details.
The Emir of Daura, Alhaji Umar Farouk Umar, said President Muhammadu Buhari needs collective prayers to surmount challenges confronting his administration. He said the people of Daura are lucky to produce Muhammadu Buhari as Nigerian president at this critical moment where the country is bedeviled with serious problems. The Emir of Daura said he is confident that President Muhammadu Buhari is capable of overcoming these challenges. Alhaji Umar Farouk Umar urged members of the forum to build bridges of unity and understanding among Nigerians with a view supporting President Muhammadu Buhari's administration. Senator Mustafa Abubakar, representing Southern Kaduna Senatorial Zone, said it is incumbent upon people of Daura Emirate to support President Muhammadu Buhari as the ambassador of the Emirate for him to succeed. He also called on federal government to adopt a pragmatic approach in addressing desertification in the area. Other speakers decried continued desert encroachment and environmental degradation, held the need for federal and federal governments to confront the problems headlong. In Katsina, Aminu Ishak Abbas, NTA News.
Cameroonian health and security officials have commenced the treatment of a suspected female suicide bomber who claims to be one of the 219 missing Chibok schoolgirls. A statement by the senior special assistant to the president on media and publicity, Garba Shehu, says the girl, aged about 12, was found heavily drugged and had several injuries on her body. The statement further adds that her accomplice was about 30 years old or more, and they both spoke only in Kanuri language. In the meantime, the Ministry of Women Affairs, the Nigerian High Commission in Cameroon, and other agencies of government will continue to work together with other stakeholders to verify all the issues. By strength shall no man prevail, but by God. These words were at the back of the minds of the police force during a special service to mark Police Week. Bonaventure Ngwodo was there for NTA News.
The Thanksgiving service is specifically to give glory to God, seek His guidance and wisdom in their quest to advance effective policing. IGP Solomon Arase took the first reading, while DIG Dan Azumidoma read the second lesson. And Pastor Omotola Adebayo reminded people on why they should remain thankful to God.
When you thank God, He comes in, He takes over your battle, and He fights to make sure that you become what He wants you to be.
The police also prayed for President Muhammad Buhari, legislature and judiciary, Nigerian citizens, and peace in our nation.
Being police officers, our job is so strenuous, so difficult. So you actually need the presence of God, you know, to be able to guide you.
The Primate Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion, Right Reverend Nicholas Oku, thank the IGP for recovering kidnapped girls in Lagos. In Abuja, Bonaventure Wood, NTA News.
And back to the Easter celebrations. Now, Christians in Niger State converged on places of worship to celebrate Easter with messages of hope, love and reconciliation for spiritual, national growth and development. Anglican Bishop of Bida Diocese, Right Reverend Jonah Kulu, led a service there. Jones Ajayi reports.
At the Cathedral Church of St. John, Anglican Bishop of Bida Diocese, Right Reverend Jonah Kulu, said with the resurrection of Jesus Christ, there is hope that Nigeria will regain her lost glory.
He said, I have authority to lay my life down and to take it up again and to give hope to all who died under sin.
Jesus came and died in place for all, so that the destruction that the all would have suffered, He took the same upon Himself.
At Our Lady, Queen of Peace Catholic Church, Christians also converge to give thanks to God for witnessing yet another Easter with songs of praise. While at the First Baptist Church, the minister in charge, Reverend Joseph Baba Shola, led the congregation in special prayers for peace and stability of the nation. The Festival of Praise and Prayers was also held. The convener and former Minister of Information, Professor Jerry Gena, called on Nigerians to have love for their country and be willing to sacrifice their life, time and talent so that the country can be peaceful and prosperous. In Bida, Jones Ajayi, NTA News.
And in Nasarawa State, Christians have been urged to imbibe the spirit of forgiveness, love and peace. Clergymen in Kefi, Karu and Maraba emphasize this on Easter Sunday. Suraj Abdullahi has the details.
Preaching on different themes and in different churches visited, the clergymen had one thing in common, that the death and resurrection of Christ brought redemption on earth. Hence, putting into practice the good virtues of Christ is a sure way to eternal bliss and salvation.
It's the resurrection that changes everything. It brought life, it brought peace, it brought joy to the entire world.
I'm expecting all the believers all over the world to know that God has a plan for all of us.
Worshippers believe that imbibing the lessons of Easter, Nigeria and the world at large will witness more peace and rapid development.
Just like Christ was obedient to His Father, for all of us as Christians to be obedient to our leaders.
We all as Nigerians must reflect on the virtue of the fact that Jesus Christ gave His life.
From Kefi, Suraj Abdullahi, NTA News.
Time now to join Ademola in our Lagos studios for more reports. Ademola, hope you had a fine Easter.
Yes, Cyril, we had a low-key Easter here due to the fear of scarcity. Welcome to Lagos. Christians all over the world commemorated Easter as the day Jesus Christ rose from the dead, redeeming mankind from condemnation. In Lagos, church services were held to mark the day, during which Christians were reminded of the need to have absolute faith in God.
At the Methodist Church of Nigeria, His Eminence Samuel Uche urged Christians and all Nigerians to continue to identify with Jesus Christ, live exemplary lives, and shun corruption. He said that as Jesus Christ made a selfless sacrifice for humanity, Nigerians should emulate him by showing love to one another.
The resurrection of Jesus Christ brought hope to humanity that God is always in charge.
In the same vein, First Reverend Alfred Adewale Martins at the Holy Cross Cathedral reminded Christians of the supreme price the Lord Jesus Christ paid to save mankind from total damnation.
It means for us that the death of Christ is not in vain, but that by his death he has given us life, by his death he has given us hope.
The Lord Bishop of Diocese of Lagos Mainland, Archbishop Adebayo Akinde, said that Christians should endeavor to live for what Jesus Christ died for.
By his resurrection, he has offered us salvation. Salvation which leads us to live a life of freedom.
Members of the sanctified Mount Zion Church were in high spirits as they praised God for sending his only son to save the world.
The message of the cross is love. And all Nigerians should learn to love one another.
The crucifixion and eventual resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ on Easter Sunday is the basis of Christianity.
Economic development and national stability can only be achieved in an atmosphere of religious tolerance and harmony. The Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Olurunti Adebole, said this at an event tagged Walk for Religious Harmony, organized by NASFAT in Lagos. Musa Toliat completes the report.
It was a real show of religious tolerance, brotherhood, and togetherness when various Islamic and Christian organizations came together to preach religious harmony through the 4.50-kilometer walk. The event, which flagged off from Obalaji Bank Anthony Way in Ikeja, saw participants walk through Kodesa Street to Awolowo Way down to Alausa Central Mosque. Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Olurunti Adebule, urged participants and adherents of Christianity and Islam to strengthen the bond of friendship and brotherhood with a view to sustaining peaceful coexistence in the state.
We enjoin all Lagosians to continue to live in peace. That is the only way we can even provide the dividends of democracy.
Commissioner for Home Affairs, Abdul Hakim Abdulatif, assured participants of government support for various initiatives hinged on promoting peace and stability across the metropolis.
We must begin to sensitize people that extremist tendencies must be done away with.
If we can look at each other and work together in peace, it means we can live together in peace.
Some of the participants bared their minds on the inter-religious event.
It's just like a family coming together during a festive period.
We should be abreast. If those things are there, they'll begin to see how we focus.
There'll be a mutual collaboration in bringing about development in Lagos State.
Free health screening session was given to those who participated. In Lagos, Musa Toliat, NTA News.
As Christians all over the world celebrated the resurrection of Jesus Christ on Easter Sunday, Household of God Church commemorated the event in a grand style. Jane Ojukwu reports that the senior pastor of the church, Reverend Chris Okotie, enjoined Nigerians to love one another even as Christ loved the world.
That was the characteristics of Household of God Church in celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The senior pastor, Reverend Chris Okotie, admonished Nigerians to emulate Christ, who died and resurrected to redeem mankind.
One Mary representing the woman in the garden, another Mary representing Israel, and the third Mary representing the Church of the Living God, all looking at the source of salvation, Christ Jesus, hanging on a cross.
He shed more light on the significance of Easter and the role of Christ in the reconciliation of man back to God.
It is beyond the amplitude of any finite cerebral capacity, beyond anything we can imagine or conceptualize. See, so he talks about the power. What is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe? According to the working of his mighty power. That's where you have the four words. What is the exceeding greatness of his power? Dunamis to us who believe, according to the working energeia of his mighty kratos power iskos. All of them together working in tandem to raise Jesus and the church from the dead. And it is something that we are excited about.
There was a drama sketch on the resurrection of Christ. The service witnessed demonstration of love and sharing as some of the members went home with various gift items. In Lagos, Jane Ujuku, NTA News.
Well, that does it from Lagos. We now take a break for some messages, after which the news continues from Abuja. Stay with us.
My father said opportunity knocks every minute. He used to say to me that even the rising sun is an opportunity. A man must give each day everything. I live by those words. Just 1 minute of one day can change everything. Every day he stepped out with the belief that today might just be that day.
At FCMB, we believe every day is a new opportunity. Let's help you step forward and take it. FCMB, my bank and I.
Home agents, this is your biggest mission yet. We've developed something entirely new. Easy Flex Evolution.
Evolution?
It changes everything the world knows about value. You now can choose between two plans. Easy Flex Data Plus, which gives you all the data you need, plus talk time. Or Easy Flex Voice Plus, which gives you three times the talk time and includes a data plan. No matter what you choose, you get the best of both worlds.
This is powerful. There's never been anything like it with so much
value. So what's the mission?
There's some who try to keep this from getting out there. Your mission, deliver Easy Flex Evolution to everyone in one piece. Suit up. From now on, it's up to you. You've been briefed.
Tea exotic nectar in pineapple, coconut, malty fruta, and other exotic flavors. The taste will take you there. Tea exotic nectar, escape to paradise.
House of Chi.
Does your antiseptic liquid kill the germs that cause flu, diarrhea, typhoid? Dettol does. Dettol provides 10 times more protection versus leading competition. Dettol is the number one selling antiseptic liquid, proven to protect from up to 100 illness-causing germs. So why take a risk with your loved ones?
As a 21st century mom, I try to find balance in everything I do, thanks to my fantastic new meal partner, Tastic. Tastic, everything is so much easier. Just look at this new quality pasta. Rich, golden color, cooks perfectly, and doesn't stick. Now that's my fantastic Tastic.
It's got to be Tastic.
Well, everything doesn't always go as planned, but mealtimes are always perfect with Tastic.
Now you know why she's the star of the family, and her workplace too.
It's got to be Tastic.
Serve
fantastic new Tastic, your perfect meal partner.
Thanks for staying with us. The Nigerian Stock Exchange records almost 40% increase in February, and experts advocate strict compliance with international financial reporting standards. That's in Business News with Leah Katung Babatunde.
Hello and welcome to Business News at 9. Financial markets remained closed Monday in commemoration of the Easter holiday as declared by the federal government. However, they would open Tuesday along with every other business institution. Now, total transactions at the nation's bourse increased by 39.44% from 84.1 billion naira recorded in January 2016 to 117.27 billion naira in February 2016. In comparison to the same period in 2015, total transactions decreased by 36.44% from the 184.49 billion naira recorded in February 2015. The Nigerian Stock Exchange, in a publication, reveals that domestic investors significantly outperformed foreign investors by 27.04%. Now, Nigeria needs to do more in enhancing its public finance reforms to promote qualitative service delivery. Experts say this is necessary in view of government's desire to cut expenses and curb leakages.
The federal government has approved that and every president has to fall in line. The whole country, state or local government, have to prepare accounts on IFSA's accurate basis.
The DBT about this thing is that this is not an initiative of government. It is not an initiative of federal. It is what the accountancy profession worldwide believes we should be headed. In order for us to have transparency, completeness and comparability of financial info.
Nigeria adopted the International Public Sector Accounting System, IPSAS, in 2012 as part of the public finance strategy to improve service delivery. IPSAS are a set of accounting standards issued by the IPSAS board for use by public sector entities around the world in the preparation of financial statements. These standards are based on International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS, issued by the International Accounting Standards Board, IASB. And that's business news for this hour. Thanks for watching.
The Barin Power Station by the National Integrated Power Project in Bayelsa State will undergo first fire tomorrow, Tuesday, as part of technical and reliability commissioning. In a statement, the General Manager Communication and Public Relations of the organization, Yakubu Lawal, says the total capacity expected on the national grid by the first unit is 113 megawatts. Bahrain will be the 8th power station to be delivered on the grid out of 10 under the NIPP. This is NTA News at 9. Dauju is in our Ibadan Network Center. Let's go over to her for more reports. Good evening, Dauju.
Good evening, Cyril. Good to see you. Hello and welcome to Ibadan. Visits to various recreation centers and share of love climaxed the Easter celebration in Ibadan. Correspondent Femi Afolabi reports that religious leaders advised Christians to renew their faith in Christ.
The lessons of love and unity amongst people taught by Jesus was at play at the various recreational and fun centers in Ibadan as residents trooped out in their numbers to celebrate Easter Monday. There were lots of entertainment in form of music, dance and games with lots to do and eat at the centers. The various worship centers were full of people to celebrate the resurrection of Christ for the joy and salvation brought to mankind.
The death did not hold Jesus back from resurrecting. It means our economy can bounce back, our political system can come back.
There are crises in life. There's anyone that believes God is able to be able to overcome them.
Religious leaders in their messages urged Christians to preach the gospel of Christ across all frontiers and have a renewed hope to overcome difficult times.
And that's our contribution from Ibadan. It's back to you, Cyril, in Abuja. Good evening.
Thank you, Dauju. The Minister of Agriculture and Rural Development, Audu Ogbe, has reassured Nigerian youths that with total commitment, agriculture can take them to their desired pride of place. It wasn't a message to a presentation on urban green area farming from the ECOWAS Youth Organization. Timothy Yusuf reports.
Youth unemployment and joblessness in Nigeria, ECOWAS sub-region and indeed Africa have become a serious concern which calls for concerted effort to tackle them. The situation is also described to be alarming, such that in every 10 Nigerian youths, 7 are jobless. The drop in oil revenue is said to have escalated joblessness and as well dwindled the economy.
At the time, in Nigeria's economy depended on agriculture. But when oil came, the whole thing changed.
It is for this reason that the ECOWAS Youth Organization is seeking collaboration with the Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development to provide over 10 million jobs through urban green area farming and youth farm settlement.
For Federal Ministry of Agriculture, we are talking of facilitation, supervision and collaboration.
The Minister of Agriculture, Chief Audu Ogbe, in a message promised the present administration's commitment to diversifying the economy using agriculture as one of the key drivers.
We want the youth to come out of their shell and be part of the system. Agriculture is the way now.
The ECOWAS Youth Organization endorsed 3 national players and 2 indigenous national coaches as role models.
In Abuja, Timothy Yusuf, NTA News.
Take another quick break for more messages. We'll be right back.
Interfaith unity, peace and tolerance amongst Nigerians is the focus on NTA Tuesday Live this week. It is informative, educative and enlightening. Tuesday Live, don't be told. Join us.
You get 3 kinds of moms. The paranoid mom.
It's hot and it's dirty.
The cautious mom. And the Dettol mom. Only a Dettol mom knows that ordinary soaps aren't enough. She only trusts Dettol to protect her family from up to 100 illness-causing germs, which is why you can worry less and love more. Don't just be any mom. Be a Dettol mom. Dettol. Be 100% sure.
Helen!
Would you like some water? It's cold, especially for you.
Which era are you living in? We have a fridge.
When everything else in your house is from the present, then why are your toilet cleaning methods from the past? Harpic, all in one for you. Compared to other toilet cleaners, Harpic removes top stains, kills all germs, and removes bad odors. For a shining clean and fresh toilet.
Wow.
You should also take the Harpic
all in one challenge.
Algerian military helicopter crashes, killing 12 soldiers. Plus, Pakistan Prime Minister promises to bring to book perpetrators of Easter bombings. These and more on Global Tidbits with Gabriel Odu.
The Russian-made Mi-171 military helicopter came down while on a mission in the Tamaraset region near the Algerian capital, Algiers. Military sources say the cause of the crash is yet to be ascertained. From Africa now, the Belgian police have released CCTV footage to enable them to identify and arrest the 3rd attacker at Brussels airport, whose bomb could not explode and ran away. The death toll from the attack has risen to 35. In Pakistan, the Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, in a meeting with security chiefs, says those that carried out the Easter bombings in Lahore that left more than 70 people dead must face the full wrath of the law. Meanwhile, a Taliban splinter group has claimed responsibility for the attack. That's Global Tidbits. Gabriel Odu, NTA News.
Sports now, and the Super Eagles hopeful of a away victory against the Pharaohs, with Jason Day earning another match play crown. Amanzi Marcus reports.
Nigeria Super Eagles on Monday left Abuja for Alexandria, Egypt for the reverse fixture of the 2017 Gabon AFCON qualifier to be decided Tuesday. Tuesday. Ahead of their departure, coach Samson Siasia and Super Eagles captain Mikel Obi said the team has to win in Egypt after a 1-1 draw last Friday in Kaduna. Meanwhile, the Confederation of African Football has banned Chad from AFCON 2017 with a $20,000 fine for withdrawing from the qualifiers. The Football Federation of Chad had on Sunday informed CAF of its withdrawal due to financial constraints, and in accordance with Article 61 of the regulations of the competition, all results involving Chad are annulled. Since Chad belongs in Group G of the AFCON 2017 qualifiers, the new table still has Egypt leading with 4 points, Nigeria second with 2 points, and Tanzania with a solid 3 points from 2 matches. Australian Jason Day celebrated his return to world number one with his second WGC match play crown on Sunday, beating Louis Oosthuizen 5-4 in the title match. Day was assured of regaining the world number one ranking on Saturday when he reached the semi-finals as American Jordan Spieth was eliminated in the round of 16.
I've really enjoyed this golf course. I've been able to not only utilize the great short game that I've had from last week to this week, but to be able to play the way I did from tee to green and then on top of it.
They joined Tiger Woods and fellow Australian Geoff Ogilvie as multiple match play winners. He won his first title in 2014 in Arizona before the tournament adopted its current round-robin format for the first 3 days. With sports news updates, Amanzi Marcus, NTA News.
Now for a quick check on the weather.
Hazy conditions after the monsoon-like rains that affected them recently. This was because the northern hemispherical low pressure system was in phase with our weather systems, pulling moisture far inland. This situation has changed slightly as we now have a high pressure replaced over there, and the intertropical discontinuity has moved slightly southwards, keeping the northern and central states under dry conditions. And so we expect those haze to affect the extreme northern part of the country. And if you are anywhere around the neighborhood of Lokoja, Abuja, Makurdi, Nasarawa, Bida, Mina, sunny conditions are most appropriate with very little chance of cloudiness. And as we move further southward, we expect cloudiness over the entire south with chances of thundery showers over the coastal areas, the inland of the south, and the high grounds of the Mambila in the afternoon and evening hours. And here's a temperature forecast. And that's it from the Nigerian Meteorological Agency. Thank you for watching.
The weather report concludes Network News tonight. Thank you for watching. Good night.
Information, entertainment.